Welcome to the Corp Vault channel. In this series, we started discussing deduplication engines. In our previous video, we covered how to recover deduplication database when it goes corrupt. In this video, we will continue discussing the other options. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. The next option to discuss is sealed deduplication database. You can plan for sealing the DDB during these scenarios. When the data on the disk is unreadable due to disk corruption or other hardware issues. When the size of data managed by the DDB needs to be controlled for data pruning on the cloud storage library. When using deduplication to tape, the active DDB can be sealed in different ways. First method is on demand, which is by using this option. We will discuss it in detail in a bit. The second way is periodically, based on the rules for DDB creation. Right-click on the DDB, and select Properties. Storage Policy Copy Properties. Deduplication tab. Settings sub-tab. Deduplication database creation. Use these options to automatically seal the existing DDB, and create the new DDB, when the data size, or days, or months, reach a selected value. The first option, create new DDB, every n days. When this option is selected, a new DDB is created later than the specified number of days. The second option, create new DDB, every n terabytes. When this option is selected, a new DDB is created, when the existing DDB reaches the specified size. The third option, create new DDB, every n months, starting from. When this option is selected, a new DDB is created every month, based on the time interval in months. You can create a new DDB, with option 1 and 2 selected. If both the options are set, a new DDB will be created, if either one of the two conditions is satisfied. You can create a new DDB, just with option 3 as well. And the last way to seal a DDB is, incidentally, based on, seal and start new DDB automatically, on detection of inconsistency, which is by using the DDB availability option. When the DDB is in invalid state, or is offline, the DDB is recovered through a dedupe reconstruction job, based on the DDB recovery options, set here. By default, the DDB has the automatic recovery option enabled, on the storage policy copy, to automatically recover the DDB from the DDB backup. Choose appropriate settings, to recover the DDB, when it is detected as invalid. Seal and start new DDB, automatically on detection of inconsistency. When this option is selected, if DDB, or one of the partition of the DDB is found offline, or invalid, the DDB, includes all partitions, is automatically sealed, and a new DDB is created. If allow jobs to run to this copy, while at least, n partitions are available, option is enabled, and if one of the partitions goes offline, sealing and start of a new DDB is prevented, and the backups continue to run, via the other active partition, or partitions. Pause and recover current DDB. This option is enabled by default. With this option selected, the DDB partition is automatically reconstructed, from the DDB backup, when the system detects that the DDB partition is offline or unavailable for use. For partitioned DDB, If a reconstruction job is already running for an offline partition of the DDB, and if another partition goes offline during this job, the reconstruction job for the offline partition starts only when the existing job is finished. Before you begin sealing the DDB, ensure that there is no DDB move jobs are running. Ensure that all the partitions in the DDB are on the same version of media agent. Otherwise, the DDB cannot be sealed. Verify if for database agents, the backup jobs are in running or suspended. If yes, then to proceed with sealing, wait for the backup jobs to complete or kill all the jobs. Sealing the DDB process might require more space on the disk library, as the new baseline for backup is created after sealing. Therefore, make sure that there is enough space available on the disk. To manually seal the DDB, when ready, click Seal Deduplication Database. Confirm Seal DDB pop-up window. This window tells you that the DDB sealing requires X amount of free space available on the disk library to create a new baseline under the new DDB. You can view the estimated baseline size of a new DDB from here as well. You can also get this information in the Storage Policy Copy Properties window on the Deduplication tab on the DDB Information sub-tab. To continue, click Yes on the confirmation message. Sometimes, a message appears that tells you that the DDB sealing requires double the amount of disk space on the library, and asking the amount of free space available on the disk. Type the space available for sealing the DDB, and then click OK. When the DDB is sealed, this event message appears in the Event Viewer window. When the DDB is sealed, the sealing process closes the DDB and starts a new DDB. When the new database is started, the next instance of each data block processed creates a new signature tracking entry, and the data block is written to the disk again as a new initial baseline. Therefore, always make sure that there is enough space available on the disk before sealing the DDB. The sealed DDB is automatically deleted only after all the jobs with their data block signatures stored on the DDB are aged or deleted, and the corresponding volumes are deleted from the disk. Lastly, you can also seal the DDB using XML. Download the DDB sealing XML file from CMVL documentation site and save it on a computer where the command is run. You can type these commands in text document and save it with XML extension to make it an XML file. There are two ways to execute this XML file. One way is to edit the XML and change details in it and save it. Storage policy name is the name of the storage policy. Copy name is the name of the storage policy copy where you want to seal the DDB. The other way is to define them in the command while executing. Open command prompt with admin privileges. Browse to software installation directory, base folder. Log on to the CMServe computer using qlogin command. Run the following qoperation command with already edited XML file. Run the following command by substituting the parameter values in the command line. Once the command is successfully executed, you will see the DDB is sealed. We will end this video here and discuss the other options in our next video. Please hit the like button if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.